Are you interested in working with cutting-edge technology, solving real-world problems, and working behind the scenes in national security? There's something for everyone in the world of geospatial intelligence. And here's 10 jobs that I absolutely love. My name is Nick, and I've been in the geospatial intelligence field for almost 20 years now. I'm the founder and CEO of GeoOwl, and we support a lot of geospatial intelligence missions around the world. As we go through the list, I'll reveal my favorite and let you know what I think. Number one is geospatial analyst. If you love maps and data, this is your dream job. As a geospatial analyst, you get to analyze data from all sorts of sources, and you throw it all together into some type of geographic information system, and then you get to analyze that data to reveal answers. It's a super cool job, and it applies to almost every single industry. Number two is imagery analyst. An imagery analyst specializes in analyzing images from things like satellites or drones. Imagine identifying hidden military equipment or predicting natural disasters before they happen. You get to analyze things like electro-optical imagery, infrared imagery, or synthetic aperture radar. I'll throw a link in the description for a podcast I did with the co-founder of Umbra. They're a company that specializes in synthetic aperture radar. If you're an imagery analyst, you're definitely gonna wanna check that out. Moving on, number three, data scientist. There's lots of different types of data science, but geospatial data scientists are built a little bit differently. As a data scientist, you'll develop models that uncover patterns in vast data sets. And if you want to know where the most data exists, it's in geospatial databases. It's all about turning that data into actionable intelligence, building tools, and helping analysts do what they do best. The geospatial data scientist is absolutely vital to pushing the limits of what we can do with geospatial intelligence. Now on to number four, one of my absolute favorites, cartographer. Cartographers are the artists of the geoint world. You'll design maps that help people visualize complex information in simple ways. If you love creativity with a purpose, this job is all about turning data into beautiful, easy to understand maps. From understanding our waterways to understanding our highways, the cartographer is absolutely vital to geospatial intelligence. Jumping into number five, geospatial software developer. As a geospatial software developer, you'll build tools that help analysts and decision makers understand and use geospatial data. You're not just coding, you're creating solutions that absolutely matter. Nothing happens in the geospatial intelligence space unless we have great software that we can use to crunch our numbers and understand the data. Number six, geoint analyst. I'm talking about a military-focused geospatial intelligence analyst, a geoint-focused military analyst. I've been a geospatial intelligence analyst, so I'm completely biased. This is my favorite job. But if you're into supporting national security operations, geospatial intelligence analyst is absolutely the perfect position for you. Every service branch has some type of geospatial intelligence element, and that's usually where you'll gain your experience before moving on to a career in geospatial intelligence. Now, I'm the founder and CEO of GeoOwl. We've been supporting geoint operations around the world for over a decade, and I can tell you that this is one of the most rewarding careers you could possibly have. You'll use geoint to support missions, track threats, and help people make really great national security decisions. The work you do absolutely will have a great impact on the world, and it will take you places that you could never imagine. And by the way, if you care about geoint, I definitely recommend subscribing to this channel right now and staying up to speed with everything geospatial intelligence. Number seven, LiDAR analyst. LiDAR is like an X-ray vision for the Earth. As a LiDAR analyst, you'll use lasers to create 3D models of landscapes, cities, and forests. If you geek out over tech like autonomous vehicles and smart cities, and geospatial intelligence has so many different use cases for LiDAR. Number eight, remote sensing scientist. Remote sensing scientists work with data from all sorts of sources, including satellites and drones, to monitor everything from environmental changes to urban development. You'll help track deforestation, monitor climate change, and even predict crop yields. Number nine, human geographer. This job is perfect for those who are fascinated by how people interact with the environment. You'll study migration patterns, urban growth, and how societies change over time. It's a blend of sociology, geography, and intelligence. In the next 60 seconds, I'm going to reveal a bonus job that nobody really thinks about, but let's keep going. Number 10, geospatial intelligence officer. If you want to lead teams and make strategic decisions, as a geoint officer, you'll manage operations, direct intelligence projects, and ensure the right information gets to decision makers. If you love leadership and strategy, this is the perfect path to make a big impact. Almost every military branch has some sort of GEOINT officer path or intelligence officer path, so I recommend checking those out. You see, geospatial intelligence is all about working with all sorts of sources. In order for it to make a lot of sense, you need to have someone that understands how to manage all that data in different databases and applications, how to convert that data from one type to the other, because everything on Earth has a location. Everything happens somewhere. If we don't have the right data, then none of it matters. And that's why the Geospatial Data Manager is my bonus job.